Hello, in today's short test we'll be testing the performance of popular thermal pastes and see if it makes sense to buy expensive ones. But first, if you like the content on the channel, think about subscribing, it doesn't cost you anything, so let's get started. At the beginning, let's see what thermal paste we'll test. Thermal Grizzly Kryonaut, Corsair TM30, Cooler Master, MasterGel Pro, Noctua NT-H1, Gelid GC-Extreme, EK Ectotherm, Arctic MX4 and Arctic MX2, Be Quiet DC1 and Arctic Silver Ceramique 2. The test setup consists of an Intel Core i7-10700K processor, overclocked to 5.1 GHz with 1.35 V-core and an LLC at level 6. The NZX Kraken X63 cooling was used for the testing. Each paste was submitted to a heating process for 1 hour and then 3 tests of 15 minutes each with a 5-minute interval between tests were performed. Full list of the test setup is in the video description. Now let's move on to the charts and see the results. All in all, as you can see, most thermal pastes currently offer very good performance. It is not surprising that the Thermal Grizzly Kryonaut performed the best and is a good choice for people who want the lowest possible temperatures. Negative surprise is a Corsair paste, which is expensive and offers average performance. One of the most interesting offers is Arctic MX2 paste, which is reasonably priced and has a nice performance. Most pastes offer similar performance, greater differences can be observed in price of the product and resistance to aging. It is worth mentioning that when applying the paste, do not apply too much of it, because the larger the layer between the processor and the cooling, the worse heat dissipation is. Finishing the test, I would like to thank you for watching, and if you like the test, please like the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care!